The delay was unavoidable. We were stopped by two members of the Surveillance Committee of the Order of Flesh and Blood, and I was questioned.
Is the duplication satisfactory, Acto? It has to be perfect.
The structure is excellent. The pores should be larger. And he needs a little more hair. Thicker. He needs a 1/8-inch mole behind the lobe of the left ear.
Report back to duplication immediately and have the corrections made.
You can still alter your decision if this is against your circuits.
My circuits are undefended.
Is the manifesto of Mother Monster. On Goat, a government-owned alien territory in space, a birth of magnificent and magical proportions took place. But the birth was not finite. It was infinite.
Raven's operation will convert him to an R-96 with all the emotions of a human.
Only 4 points less than human.
This is the manifesto of Mother Monster.
I wonder what it's like.
You will learn how to laugh, how to cry. Be afraid and hate. To become an R-96. Is a real sacrifice. With this one, we will have 16. 10 males and 6 females.
At times, I think we should turn the entire program over to the humans.
It really shouldn't be the responsibility of robots.
The humans aren't ready for it yet. It's still illegal to improve a robot higher than an R-70.
That law was lobbied through by the Order of Flesh and Blood.
The Order is becoming more powerful every day. They virtually dictate to the police.
There are always ultra-conservative pressure groups set against advancement.
Why? Why? It's not in the best interests of humans to hold back the development of robots.
They won't for long.
As the wombs numbered and the mitosis of the future began, it was perceived that this infamous moment in life is not temporal. It is eternal.
We're filling key positions with R-96s as fast as we got them.
I still have an occasional doubt.
You may withdraw if you're contra-circuited.
I'm unoffended.
Mark, you better go down and join the volunteer. Hurry things along. The human he replaces has already been out of circulation for 4 hours. The less time a man is unaccounted for, the better.
And thus began the beginning of the new race. A race within the race of humanity. A race which bears no prejudice, no judgment, but boundless freedom. But on that same day, as the Eternal Mother hovered in the multiverse, another more terrifying birth took place.
According to the latest tabulations by the brain, by the first of next month, we will outnumber the humans.
Hey, your lab did another excellent job. He's an exact duplicate of that deceased human your clicker pals brought in tonight.
What did you do with that body?
The usual. Processed it, then destroyed it. Everything we need from it is right here.
The birth of evil. And as she herself split into two, rotating in agony between two ultimate forces, the pendulum of choice began its dance. It seems easy, you imagine, to gravitate instantly and unwaveringly towards good. But she wondered, how can I protect something so?
How are my other transplants doing?
Quite well.
So perfect, without evil.
Who was this man?
I only know he'd been drinking. Probably killed in a brawl. The clickers that found him removed all of his identification.
Will the drinking have any effect upon the operation?
It'll be interesting to see. What are you doing with these advanced models?
We send them out to intermingle with humans, to find out why some of them despise us so much. Then we can adjust and be accepted.
That's admirable, logical, and a lie. What are you using them for?
When is his interview time?
Same as the others. From 4 to 5 a.m., he'll know he's an R96 and give you any information he's gotten in the interim. Other than that period of 1 hour, he'll think he's whoever that corpse was.
How often does he report to the father mother for recharging?
Twice a year, but he won't know it.
Make it once a year.
He won't last as long.
What's 20 or 30 years? In 150 years, he's automatically renewed anyway.
Whatever you say.
Brothers, that which we greatly feared has come upon us. The robots have circumvented the prime law. They've tasted blood, and there are millions of them. This is catastrophe.
Fellow men, I have analyzed the subject robot as thoroughly as time permitted. He is a basic R34 type, but certain alterations have elevated him to a mid-90 classification.
Mid-90? But an R100 would be one of us.
A perfect man, as good as we are.
He'd be better. He'd be perfect. Which of us could match that?
Just put your paws up, because you were born this way, baby.